Well, Valentine Day is coming up this Thursday, and you know what would be really romantic? If you didn't set the house on fire while you're trying to make the perfect meal for your loved one. So just a quick few safety tips, then we're going to talk about how to cook the perfect steak. First of all, with the grill, if you hear nothing else, don't ever light a grill with the hood down. So when you're hitting that little button and you've turned on the gas, this should always be up. All right. If not, gas can gather down there. You can have an explosion. Make sure you clean the grill, the grid, and then also the underneath tray where you can get some fires. And nothing that's less romantic is if you run out of gas. So a tank is 38 pounds full. It's 18 pounds empty. So 18 to 38, that is the gas that's in your tank. So make sure that you have enough gas to make the perfect steak or whatever you're making for your loved one. As for the food safety tip, if you're bringing the raw meat out on this, you're not taking it back in on that. Get a separate plate and do your loved one a favor. Get yourself a good thermometer, all right? Now, this is Chef Nick Frigi. He's our chef here at the store. He's going to show us how to be a little more romantic with the perfect steak. Nick,
all right. What so do you right got now, here? We have a New York strip that I've kind of let sit out on some herbs, thyme, and rosemary over here just to soak up that flavor. And then right here, a nice tip for you is always grill what you're cooking, not what you're cooking on. So you don't want to oil the grate, per se. You want to oil your food.
Oh, interesting.
So this is just a nice little mixture of olive oil and canola oil. Then a Montreal steak seasoning. I like a nice homemade Montreal steak seasoning for that.
And what we're going to be doing... Everyone does. I make my own. Yeah.
What we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing a reverse sear here. So I set this grill up. See beautiful smoke coming out of there. I set this up bullseye. That means all the charcoal is right here in the center.
Okay.
That's going to create my sear zone. So when I say reverse sear, you can imagine I'm doing it a little bit backwards than normal. So I'm going to put my New York strip on indirect heat till it gets to about 110 degrees. So we're just going to put that one on there too. Once the steak's at 100,
do you flip it?
No, you don't have to flip it on this stage because you're not getting any sear marks on there right now. So once this steak, and again, always want to check with the thermometer. I like my steaks to be a great medium rare. So I'm going to go to 110 degrees, 110. Once it's there, I'm just going to take this steak. I'm going to get a nice sear on there. We're going to go shut this down because if you're looking, you're not cooking, right? So we're going to shut that down. Imagine we went 45 seconds. Got a really beautiful sear on there. Open it back up. Flip it. Now when you flip, you want to go to a new spot on your bullseye because you're taking all the energy for the sear where it is right now. So we're going to flip this. New spot. Get a nice new sear on there. Shut that down again.
And that's what the cool kids are doing,
that's
right?
That's what the cool kids are doing. The reverse sear.
Much more even steak. And that's how you have the perfect Valentine's Day dinner. It's beautiful. Thank you, Nick.
No problem.